Hello everyone, I'm Jonathan.
I'm Crystal.
And this is Garbage Horror, continuing the Haunt Review series for 2014, as we head south from Ellis, Mississippi, and visit Lumberton, Mississippi, for the Terror Test. Now, this is a haunt we did not visit in 2013.
No.
We did not feel compelled. We skipped. And we did go in 2012, and we did review it. And judging from the thumbs up, thumbs down ratio, I get the sense that review was not highly appreciated by certain people.
Yeah, I don't think that they particularly liked us.
I don't think they particularly liked us or our review. And unfortunately for you guys, not going to be too fond of this one either.
No.
And the thing is this, we want every haunt to be awesome. We want every haunt to succeed, but we also have to be honest. And part of that honesty is admitting that this haunt review is going to be difficult for me.
Right.
Because when you and I go to a haunt, we are there for two reasons.
We love haunts.
That's reason one. We're like Tigger. We want to scare ourselves to death. We want to have a haunt. We want to be frightened and be in an awesome other world. And the second part is we are haunters.
Yeah.
We run our little garage haunt. We volunteer at haunts. We love doing haunting. And so when we go to other haunts, we're trying to scope out and see what they're doing, check out new ideas, and see how they solve the problems that we encounter.
Right.
And that's fun for us, too.
Mm-hmm.
But when we are in these chairs, these very, very wobbly chairs, we're putting on the first hat, the haunt
right.
lover's hat. But it's hard to put that hat on exclusively with the terror test because of one word. Safety.
Yes. Important word.
It's a very important word. It's the most important word in haunting for my money.
Yes.
And I just did not get the feeling the terror test was an appropriately safe haunt.
No.
I mean, we were in a group of five people.
Yes.
It was me, you, our girlfriend Ellie, and two guys that just happened to show up at the same time.
Right.
We didn't know these two.
No, one of which was using a cane to get around.
Yeah, he seemed pretty ambulatory, but
yeah.
he was still using the cane for some assistance.
Right.
But he was definitely walking fine for most of it.
Yeah.
You know, it starts off with going through a tunnel of trees type thing.
Yeah, that's right after the graveyard scene, actually.
No, it's before this.
Okay.
I believe you went to the graveyard
scene. Maybe
it's
both.
But you're going through like a forest path, which was not cut back.
No, it was very much overgrown.
And it was impossible to tell which way to go in places. And I actually got scratched by a couple of thorn bushes once or twice going through it.
And then the really springy branches that if the first person lets go, it just boom.
Yeah, I was lucky I was first. But
apparently
she ate a few branches along the way that I didn't know about.
Yeah.
And then later on you have bridges which are way too narrow.
Well, not only that, but it's not
lit.
Apparent. When you come up to them, that it's a bridge.
Yeah.
Or that there's a step down.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, there's rails, but you don't notice that there's a step up and down.
And
in fact, the guy that I mentioned earlier with the cane fell because of that.
Right off the bridge. Luckily, it wasn't a very far fall. He was fine.
Yeah.
But that's bad. And then there was that one incline, which was slippery, and I nearly fell on.
God, yeah.
And then there was the guy, the same dude, caught on a nail that was not hammered in at one point.
Right. You were supposed to walk through a demolition wall.
Like
pretty
between
typical
the studs.
Scene, but they had a nail sticking out. Caught
like
a
way
shirt,
out.
And it kept us, it actually held up our group for a little while, trying to get him off of that and to get everyone through safe.
And what's weird about this haunt to me is when you show up, they pretty much get in your face and tell you that if you touch the actors or do anything, you're going to jail.
Yeah.
It's. I mean, and here's the thing. Every haunt has to have rules.
Yeah.
I get that.
Yeah.
We
have
rules.
Rules.
James, you owe me a Coke.
Mm.
No. We have rules. And if you have a haunted house, I bet right now I can recite at least 90% of your rules right off the top of my head.
Yeah.
Because they're all mostly the same.
Yeah.
There aren't very many special rules, but there's a way to impress the rules upon people and, you know, make them well known that they're serious without threatening people.
Right. Don't make me feel like a criminal because I'm not going to have fun.
And then especially don't put me in a room where I am supposed to grope around and then bump into someone.
Yeah.
That's the design of the room.
Yeah.
Because then it's like, wait a minute, but I'm told if I touch anyone, they didn't even give it an exemption for incidental contact.
No.
It's like, if I touch someone, if I touch their property, I'm going to jail.
Yeah.
they make that extremely clear. I mean, at least they didn't do like in 2012 when Frisk us for weapons.
Yeah.
I mean, this is a haunt that is so obsessed with the safety of its actors, but didn't show much regard for the safety of its customers.
Right.
At least not for our group.
Yeah.
And that, to me, is just insane. I mean, mm-hmm. were there parts of the haunt that were good? Probably. Yeah. I can't tell you much, honestly.
There were a few things that I really liked. There was, actually, my favorite thing from last time was where the zombie climbed out from underneath an above-ground grave.
That was cool.
It wasn't there this year, so I kind of
missed
that.
That was the 2012 one, yeah.
Yeah, I missed that. There were better acting.
Yeah.
There was better acting towards, especially towards the middle.
Yeah.
With the guy jumping on top of the big, you know.
Yeah, I remember
trailer
that.
Things. Mm-hmm. But
I mean, and they were, the acting was somewhat hampered though, because there was two scenes where they used loud explosives.
Yeah.
And the first one in particular left my ears ringing so bad that literally, right afterward, an actor comes out and all I see is, that's seeing her here. Because I can't, I'm deaf.
Yeah. Yeah, that was way too loud for that little room.
No, that was talking about the very first one in the open air that was right beside me.
Oh.
There was, the one in the little room didn't bother me as much, but then again, I wasn't as close to that one.
Right.
So that's the thing. They do these explosives, and you happen to be the one closest to them. Mm-hmm. You're gonna be deaf for a bit, and then you can't hear the actor scream. You can't hear what's going on around you, and that's very frustrating.
Right.
Not to mention, kind of worrisome.
Well, that, and especially with the little room, it stops the flow of the action.
Yeah.
Because whenever you tell everybody to stand still in this room, you lock us in there for a few seconds. And then you just do a loud noise and then have people scream that we can't really hear. It takes you completely out of the situation.
Yeah. But, I mean, to me, most of the haunt that I remember this time, and I went back and rewatched our review from 2012 where we were talking about how there just didn't seem to be much going on.
Right.
There's definitely a lot more going on.
Yes.
But I spent so much time focused on not tripping, not hitting these lips, not slipping on in surfaces.
Right.
I mean,
now it did get better once you got inside.
Yes. Once you got inside, the construction quality, the safety, everything
other
went up.
Other
than the nail, and other than that dark room, which of course was just a mess of design.
Right, and that was at the very beginning.
Yeah.
So right after that.
Right after that, everything got better. When you the hospital sequence was pretty good.
Yeah.
The church sequence, I rather liked the design on that.
Yeah, you really liked how the pews were laid out
to
guide people.
Some very creative prop-based design taking place there. There was some cool stuff in there, and it's like I said, the inside was, I think, overall, better quality, safer, and more fun than the outside.
Right.
Especially considering, you know, you're not getting scratched by thorn bushes or eating trees to your face.
Yeah.
You know, and it's just
fun times.
Yeah, it seems odd to me that they really took such, I guess, zealousy in their safety of their actors.
Yeah.
And took, they didn't, and they wouldn't, they didn't even hammer in all the nails that we were going through.
Right.
That makes me feel very weird. I don't know. It usually haunts that we've seen have done the reverse.
Yes.
They have put overemphasis on the safety of the customers, meanwhile the actors are the ones getting stabbed by nails.
Yeah.
I have actually seen that happen. We actually had that happen to you.
Yeah.
So
me and my brother both.
Yeah.
So,
you know, so that part is just a little surreal to me. All in all, I mean, I don't know. I was really hoping to see forward progress and forward momentum, but I can't judge that very effectively.
You know, I don't remember anything new from the first time we went to this year.
Yeah. I mean, there's nothing that certainly that stands out.
No.
Everything that stood out, at the very least, was there in 2012.
Yeah.
I mean, there was new stuff. I do remember there being new stuff. I think the church sequence, for example, was new.
No, I'm not sure.
And I'm not sure, though, honestly. So there were new things, I'm sure. But, yeah, the stuff that really stands out and gets your attention was there in 2012. But, I mean, the haunt we went to in 2012 felt safe. I don't remember ever getting close to getting hurt.
Yeah, it wasn't overgrown.
It wasn't overgrown. It maybe it dialed back some things in exchange for that, but it felt safer. Right. I mean, and in some of its fundamentals, you don't have, you know, non-traditional steps in the dark.
No.
That's very difficult to climb when you can't see the steps, and it's prone to slips and accidents. Mm-hmm. You know, you want a haunted attraction should be like a roller coaster. It should feel dangerous, but not actually be dangerous.
Yeah. And we're talking about working roller coasters.
Yeah. None of our Connects roller coasters.
No.
All of which are broken thanks to the cats. Stupid cats.
Anyway.
But, yeah, that's the point. It is, what I would like to see in 2015 from these guys is to clean it up, fix these safety issues. You know, ADA, I'm not saying you have to build everything to ADA compliance. I don't know what the rules are for your fire code in your area. But for me personally, ADA is a good guide for mm-hmm. building a haunt, just because if a wheelchair can get through it, you're reasonably sure any person with two working legs can get through it safely.
Right.
So, that's just my personal take. Yeah. Like I said, I spend more time trying not to actually get hurt than enjoy the haunt.
So, would you recommend it or not?
No. I would not. I mean, I would not recommend the terror test.
Okay.
Would you?
I'm not sure. Because it...
I mean, so like I said, there's sparks of creativity, but until they clean up these safety issues, I don't want people...
It's like, once you get inside past that first room, then I would recommend it. But that outside first part, I don't recommend.
No. That's
my split decision.
Yeah, okay. that's a fair one. I think that's actually pretty fair. But, I mean, for me personally, with the safety issues I observed, I would not feel comfortable telling someone I liked and cared about to go to it.
No, because especially like if you were to trip and you braced yourself on that stud with the nail coming out.
Yeah, it could have gotten ugly.
Get stabbed.
It could have been many, many times worse for our group.
Glad it wasn't.
I hope that they fix those problems as quick as they can, but some of them seem a little bit more difficult to fix than others.
Yeah.
So that's our thought on the terror test, I think.
Yeah.
Anything else, Dan?
No.
On that note, everyone... I'm Jonathan.
I'm Crystal.
And this was Garbage Horror Haunt Review 2014 for The Terror Test in Lumberton, Mississippi. I'm not doing anything funny for this one.